Hello everyone, it's me Ilian from DM Trading Bulgarian, and the day has come for me to make a review of the trading plan I shared with you last week. This will be a pretty quick review, so if you have any questions you can post them below the video or you can just contact me directly, I'll try to answer them. The plan I shared with you was based on the Euro-USD currency pair, and mainly we were going to look for sell opportunities. It was a short-term plan on the 60 minutes time frame, which means you could either look for entries on the 60 minutes time frame, or if you don't feel comfortable enough and you want to enter a bit earlier, in this case I would have recommended the M5 time frame. Now this is the plan itself posted on TradingView. Just a few words about it. The idea here was we had two possible scenarios. Either a downtrend starting from this resistance area, maybe a slight correction from our first take profit level and a new wave down to the second take profit level, or a break of this resistance for the price to reach this second resistance area, then a wave down to our first take profit level, then again a slight correction and a new wave down reaching to the second take profit level. Let's see what happened on this plan. Okay, so as you can see, after I posted the plan, we had a strong drop. The price reached almost to our second take profit level without making a correction here. Then we had a move up from there. We were expecting that. The price once again reached this resistance area. It ranged for a while here, made a move up, almost reaching the second resistance area. And after that, as you can see, it dropped all the way to the second take profit level. Now let me show you a few possibilities where you could have entered. Now first here, it would have been hard, but you can see where the plan was posted, so this would have been kind of too late to enter. So then maybe you had some possible entries here for a very short term trade. But it would not have been taken on the H1. Then you had a small box here, which was the first good potential entry. You can see the previous top was this. So on the H1, an entry here on this candle, the break of the previous top, would have been good. After that, we had, you can see this correction to that downtrend. And after this uptrend channel was broken, you could have looked for an entry once again here, all the way to the second take profit area. Now I just want to mark where the plan was published so we can look over the M5 time frame and why it's always better to go on a lower time frame than your plan and trade there, since you have a lot more opportunities. Okay, so let me move back to where the plan was actually posted. Okay, so it was here. So here, if we turn on the Bollinger Bands, I'm quite certain, okay, we can see how the price behaved here. It made a slight box after this downtrend. So an entry here would have been great. Again, we have a box here, you can see it. So an entry here also would have been good. Now keep in mind that here we are most likely at the beginning of the downtrend wave, and here we are a lot closer to the end of our sell zone, so a lot less risk should be involved in this trade than in this trade. Then you can see we had this very long range of sorts. Maybe again here, if we consider this first take profit area as a support, then as a resistance, maybe again you could have entered somewhere here for a short term trade with the idea to reach back to this second take profit area, then moving ahead. Here you can see that after this after this uptrend here, which reached to that actually to the resistance area, you could have looked for a potential entry on this candle, the break of the uptrend channel. You can see it was going to be a good trade, at least to the first take profit area. Then we had a very long range once again, and the price reached to this almost to the second resistance area. This was basically the previous top here on the M5 as well, so you could have entered a bit earlier, maybe on this candle if you watched the M5 closely. And also here you can, let me just delete that so you can see it better, but here we had a small sort of a square formed, you can see. So the break of this square, we are basically getting a double signal here. We are breaking this square and we are breaking the previous top the price made. After that, a few more opportunities. You can see using the Bollinger's, we had a square here as well, but here the entry would have been all the way down on this huge candle, which in this case would be quite risky, but you could have tested that trade as well. Then we had another range and a slow uptrend of sorts. And then here, it was the H1 entry after breaking this uptrend channel. You see on the M5 how great this trade would have been, and all the way down to the take profit level 2, we didn't have any opportunities on the M5, and we are here now. This is it on this review. As you can see, if you look closely, either on the H1 or M5, we had some nice opportunities. I hope you managed to catch some of those. The most important thing when creating a trading plan is to define if you're only going to sell or only going to buy. Don't try doing both, as this can lead to losses instead of wins. So if you're focused only on selling in a certain area, just look for sell opportunities. Don't take the buy ones. That's it from me for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Yesterday I already shared my trading plan for this week, and next week we'll make a review of it. Thank you very much and have a good day.